Like most kids, I was into dinosaurs. I played with dinosaur toys, went to natural history museums, and made lots of dinosaur art. But I just never really grew out of dinosaurs. So my dad and I decided to make a movie about dinosaurs and the people who love them. We traveled around the US and Canada, interviewing paleontologists, artists, and dinosaur enthusiasts. And we asked everyone, why dinosaurs?
I think people love dinosaurs because they are big, they're bizarre, and they're extinct.
People are definitely fascinated by what they would have looked like, what they would have eaten, how they would have interacted.
Dinosaurs should be vividly colored, just like birds. There's nothing to stop us from having a pink T-Rex.
Jurassic Park is the iconic pop culture version of dinosaurs.
That was the first movie to ever gross $1 billion.
There were giant animals like dragons that lived before mankind.
Every time you find a new fossil, it always tells a story, so it's like a new chapter.
This bone right here was laying right on the edge of a cliff.
So you find a new species of dinosaur. Well, we gotta cut it open and see how old it is.
Everything you think you know about Stegosaurus is wrong.
There's a reason that the Field Museum paid $8 million for the biggest, most complete T-Rex that's ever been found.
So you ready to go check out the dino den?
Wow. I am a dino addict.
Dinosaurs are just kind of everywhere. They're in kids' toys, murals, tattoos.
Dinosaurs are magical, amazing creatures.
It's the babies. Like, I get so excited.
We may find something that's twice as big as a T-Rex. Who knows?
So I do think the face of paleontology has been changing over the years. Definitely a lot more women in paleontology, which is really awesome.
We are the only accredited museum on a high school campus. I wouldn't have complained going to a high school like this.
Right on, cool, man, you got it.
Don't fall.
How can you dominate the world so completely and then lose it?
And what does that say about our own success?